Hi, and welcome to this video, which will be a little update on the project that I jumped on in the beginning of the year, that is Roxy's Journal of Stitchery. Mine looked like this. I have a video showing how I got this book, made pages to go in it with my mom, and she made another one for her, how we dressed it up with fabric on the inside and started our intro pages. But since then, I've kind of not been working in my stitchery book. I have a lot of projects going all at once, so this kind of fell a little bit behind, so I need to catch up. So that's what this video is. I have my bullet journal here, and so I have been keeping up with writing down what the themes of this challenge is. So, but once I got here, vintage lace and bouncing bunny, I know what fabrics I wanted for bunny, which is a super cute one that I found at my mom's place. Yeah, so this is what I put together so far for the... I don't think any bunny can be more bouncy than Peter Bunny from Beatrice Potter's little fairy tale. So I wanted to use that piece here. I guess this is one of his sisters, but these two is him. And then for the background, it says vintage lace, so I've added in some colors because I wanted this silk green, and just stitched it to my, I don't know, page or block. And then I wanted to choose some lace from my little lace stash, but I wanted to film it, so I never did it. And then several months passed, and now we're in May, and I'm needing to catch up on all of these. So I thought we'd just pick some lace. This is my box of, I think it's ribbon and lace, but let's have a look. Yeah, so very disorganized, because I just have small bits mostly. Like, I can't really make a bobbin out of this, so it's just stuck in here with flowers and stuff. And this lifts up, and underneath we have the small but very sweet lace stash, mostly vintage ribbons bought at flea markets over the years, here in Sweden. Some are whiter than others, some are crocheted, some are tatting. This is crochet, I think. Just tiny bits, or some, I guess, mom's given me bits of her when she's found bigger bags of it. She's given me like small bits at times. So I have some, and I want to choose it for my bunny page. So let's see if we can do this. I thought I'd do just like a sampler page. Just nothing's fancy when it comes to embroidery. Just gonna hand stitch these down, like I've done with this piece and the fabrics, which is the, I think Jude Hill calls it the glue stitch, which is a tiny, tiny stitch on the front to secure two fabrics together. And then long stitches on the back to just jump all over and make sure it's glued down, to do further embellishments and embroidery on top of a fabric that has been sewn down to another fabric, like the background. So in that way you can add, make a patchwork like this, but have the raw edges still available. And I left this bit here because I know I want to add a cute lace that sticks out, like a bigger one that has a nice edge to it. So picking and choosing, definitely using this one. Isn't it horrible to cut into these beautiful things? But I've had them for a long time and I don't think I will add them to clothes. So this is a good project. Sorry about my hands. I was painting before I started this. This is so fine lace, so it's almost invisible, but I think I can bust it down so that you can see it better than when it's laying in a pile like that. Trying to vary the sizes, so how about this one here, and then this is might be my favorite. It's a bit more dense than the other ones, but I like how, I don't know, how regular it looks, and also the color, it's much more off-white than the other ones. So maybe something like that. And this will be flattened. Yeah, I changed my mind. I moved this one here and found this one, which was way too big to put down here. It would be sticking out much more than needed. And also at the bottom would just be crushed up in a book, so you wouldn't really see much of it. So I thought I'd try to add it on top. These are supposed to look like flowers, but I really think they look like dragonflies when they're scrunched up. Anyway, I just have a small piece of this. Small piece, relatively speaking. And then I'm just gonna be squishing these down a bit, adding this one here. I don't know if you can see this in front of you, but I think it will be look nice because all of this will be sticking up above the book, and I like little dangly things and threads hanging out, so I think that will be nice. I was also thinking to maybe even add either one of the lacy doilies to the corner like that, or this humongous piece, but it's gonna be so bulky because this is quite thick for lace. Yeah, maybe not. Maybe one of these little as a sun up here in the corner. I don't know, I kind of like using things like this. I need to start stitching these down. Oh, I was thinking about this one too. Should I add more color? No, I don't think so. I kind of like that it's a very pale page. Not my usual style, but it goes with this pink and green. So it's the style of the two first pages at least. We'll see what the next page is. This video is not a tutorial or like I need to show you the whole process of all of the pages. It's just a little snippets of when I've been able to film. Here I've already stitched down all of the lace bits going across the page and decided to
slowly and carefully stitch down the little doily in the corner like I planned to do. I'm using the glue stitch again, and it's perfect for securing down lace because I don't want any stitching to be actually visible. All I want is for the lace to look like it's just laying down flat and showing off all its beauty without my hand having even touched it, even though there are a million tiny stitches all over this page. So I really recommend you to try the glue stitch. And yeah, that's the process, and now we're just going to be jumping into the next page and the process of that.
So for February, the theme is natural background, or neutral background rather, and fancy flowers. And I've been struggling with this so much. There are so many ways you could do a fun background. I've been looking through my stash for kind of beiges and browns, thinking I could do a weaving, but not really feeling it, cutting apart. I have these squares that are actually very neutral in colors, and they have some fancy flowers on them. But I don't know, it's such an 80s fabric, and I don't even know where it comes from. It's definitely not my taste. So my thinking is, right now at least, I found another fabric. This is one of those beautiful tablecloths that was stained. So I colored it and dyed it. I think this has a spray painted fabric paint and some shimmer to it. I don't know if you can see it, but it's a very silver iridescent, which makes it a little bit more fancy than just neutrals. But it's definitely a neutral. And for fancy flowers, I don't want to do a big embroidery right now of a flower. I just don't feel like it. So I'm going to bring in and do some collaging again. And I have this piece. It's transparent tulip bit. And it does not fray, so it's very plasticky. So I decided to just cut out one of the little arrangements or bouquets and place it on top of the brown and neutral fabric and stitch it down somehow. Just make a simple quick page. I don't know how simple and quick it will be. Stitching is not often very stitching is just a slow thing, but this is going to be a lot quicker than me trying to make a flower, and I'm not going to be happy with the flowers I make. I already know that. So that's my February page.
To sew around my fancy flower for my February page, I found some really nice pink and brown threads, and I did this kind of tambourine stitch or spiderweb stitch. It's inspired entirely by Heidi Iverson of Honey Folk Clothing that I'm following on Instagram. She does this stitch round and round on big pieces, and it's so beautiful. I've really wanted to try this sewing around and round for I think over a year now, so it was really high time I did it. And I changed colors a couple of times and went from some different pinks, like I said, onto this a little bit thicker silver thread. I think it's actually a knitting yarn, or crochet. But since this background really worked for stitching through really easily, I thought I'd try this as an embroidery stitch on the outside of my little shape, and I think it turned out really nice. If you feel like you want to be inspired by Heidi, I suggest you go follow her on Instagram. I will link her below. She has some videos on YouTube as well, but they are not really many, I think 2 or 3. But there she shows how this stitch is done. And I think my glitter page turned out really nice. So now we're moving on to the March page. And for the background, the theme is antique or reclaimed textile. So I went into my grandma's stash and picked out this tablecloth that was already cut up. And then I just pinned down some little bits of fabric to make the focal image, which was bright butterfly. I didn't really know how to do it. I've never done a butterfly like this before, but I definitely wanted these organza fabrics and silks. And then I decided to embellish it with some of my sequins, just to make it even as glittery or as sparkly as I could. And then I added, as you can see here, ribbons to the edges. And I kind of formed the fabrics as I went along around the pinned down bits for the wings. And then I added a ribbon in the middle, so it's a little bit of space between them, because I know I wanted the body to be in between there. I didn't want to cover up the wings too much. So the body is a bright butterfly that I'm really loving, with that pink cotton ribbon as the body. I have never sewn something like this before, and I totally love it, and I can see a couple of butterflies being born in my future. It was really fun to just pick out some really cute fabrics and make her. But before she was even finished, I moved on and started my fourth page.
So for the April page, the theme is quilts, antique or old quilts, and cute cottage, I think, something like that. Don't have any quilts to cut apart, especially not, don't have any old quilts at all. Still, this idea to make a quilt of tiny little squares must be, well, it's at least um, 15 years or so since I wanted to do it, and this little patch was sewn together. But all the rest of the little bits are in a bag in my studio, so I never made a quilt. it's ironed onto a fusible backing and then sewn together, cut and folded and cut again, or sewn again. So this little nine patch was found in my box, and I thought it was fun since it alludes to these previous themes of bunny, flowers, butterflies, and favorite color as well. So I'm going to use this little block that I made. It's definitely not antique or very old, but it's at least been in my box for 15 years since I made it. And I'm going to be making a little landscape. I'm just using 2 bits of fabric and gonna stitch them together and then add on the little patch as a little cottage with a little roof from this super cute cloth that I have probably been gifted at some point, because it has sewing, like it's meant to become a garment, but then it's just this little piece that's not really enough, like a top, but it's not enough to finish. So I'm just going to be taking this little piece for the roof, using this little piece that also is a gift from someone who had a lot of scraps, and I love this fabric, kind of like this big. So I'm using it carefully, but in this book I'm going to be using this bigger piece, as well as some of the hand-painted fabrics I made in this green bits. It was a square, so I cut it to fit the page, as well as this also hand-painted fabric for the sky. So that's today's project, I think. We're a few days after I started making this video, and this is the last page I'm working on, so I'm going to show you all of them at the end of the video, but for now I'm just going to be stitching a little bit.
I filmed this bit in hyperlapse, so I don't really like that, because it gives the illusion that this is such a quick process, but I'm sure if you're watching this, you have tried embroidery and you know it's really slow. So instead of doing a glue stitch for attaching the green and the blue fabrics together, I picked a green thread and did the embroidery very visible all around where I wanted it to show. And then I decided to sew the little house square down. And after I've added that, I decided to make little I don't know what dots are called, but add the ribbon as a little border for the house. Columns, pillars. Just want to use some of my cute stash. And then sewing down the roof with the buttonhole stitch and white thread.
And that is how you make 4 pages in about 30 minutes. Or 1.5 week of intense stitching at nights. So thank you so much for staying with me during sharing this process. Some of the clips is not up to my standards, my usual standards, but I filmed at night and sitting in the sofa with my little IKEA lab table where I do my most embroidery. So that is why. So I'm just going to be sharing the finished pages as they are. The January theme was vintage lace as background and the bouncing bunny as image. So this is how the page turned out. Added a little bit of piece, a little bit of lace to the side, and this is what will be sticking up above the book when it's closed. We'll see how that works when I add it into the book. But I really like this page. It's cute. It's showing off some of my favorites from my stash. And I feel like I could do about 10 more pages like this, just of what I already own. So that makes me happy to know I have some cuteness left to use. So that's my bouncing bunny page. For February and the neutral background, I chose a painted fabric and did this, I'd call this buttonhole stitch. I don't know what it's really called, but like I said, Heidi calls it spiderweb or tambourine stitch. And she does amazing things with it, and I'm really pleased with how this turned out. There are some different threads, as well as the silver one here, and an even thinner silver thread at the edge that kind of disappears. And it really, really shimmers and shines when it's featured in the sun. So I have a bigger piece of this, and I'm definitely going to be doing something, maybe a tablecloth using this stitch for my round table perhaps later on in the year if I find the time. Right now I do not have the time, so I'm just wanting to finish these pages. Then for March I choose this fabric that is from a box of threads and fabrics I got from my grandma after she died. So, and this is from the kind of really torn and mended piece. So I wanted to use a little bit of that here and here. But otherwise, I'm really in love with this butterfly. All he needs now are some beads for the eyes. I'm going to add that in when I find my beads that I wanted to use. She's also really shimmery and shiny, and really like that. And then I did a little swirl from where she's been flying off to the into the nature page. This is my second attempt. My first attempt I used more of this fabric on and just attached it with tiny tiny stitches. And then when I was done with this page, I decided it was not what I wanted for the butterfly, because I like it as it is. The reason is I wanted to keep these mendings. They are hardly visible, but they're there. And that's my grandma who did it, and I didn't want to cover it up. So this will be a page I'm just going to be leaving as is. I don't know if I will add it into another project or just leave it as a white page at the end of the book. But it's something that is precious, and I need to keep it as it is for now. So that took a little longer since I did all that stitching and then decided not to use it. So, but that's fine. That happens sometimes. For our last page for April, we have Old Quilt and Country Cottage. And this is where I've ended my stitching. Added some little flowers at the top and some little stitches down on the one of the colors of this green fabric, and as well as a little door. I could stitch on to this page a lot more, but for now I think I feel like it's done. I'm not really happy with the roof. This fabric was fraying a lot, so I did that buttonhole stitch again, and I'm not sure it really works for this, but well, it's fine for now. So I finished all of these pages and I'm really loving all of them, and I had a really nice time doing some stitching. I don't know why it took me so long to get started, because when I do start, I love embroidery so much. I also need to finish the May page, but that will be in my next video. If you're doing this project, I would love to know how you have solved some of these problems. If you have videos or photos, leave them below. And I'd love to know which is your favorite of these four pages. And why, of course. Thank you so much for watching this video, giving it a thumbs up, and maybe subscribing if you want to update on the May pages, which will be out next week. And then probably the summer pages will be after summer, because I don't really have time for them right now. Thanks for watching. Bye.